Thank you. As president of the United States Ocarina Association and the first performer tonight, I want to extend a very warm welcome and thank all of you for coming to the first annual U.S. Ocarina Festival. My first solo concert actually took place on this very stage, so it's really great to be back here performing. Since then, I've performed around the world and even at Carnegie Hall. We have a great show for you tonight. We have a great show for you tonight, and we really hope that you enjoy it. We hope that the Ocarina Festival will become an Allen tradition for years to come. The piece you just heard was a mashup of two of the best known uses of the ocarina, The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly, and also The Legend of Zelda. Now we'll be playing a piece by the most famous ocarina in the world, a Japanese ocarina player named Sojiro-san. Thank you. Ocarinas come in all shapes and sizes. Next, I'll perform on the triple bass ocarina. As you can see, it's a lot bigger than my other ocarinas. The larger the size, the deeper the tone. Thank you. Next, I'll be playing two classical selections. Next, I'll be performing with my husband, John. This is only our second performance together. Our first performance was actually in Japan this late August. The instrument he's playing is called a handpan. We hope you enjoy our music.
Thank you.
Our next performer came all the way from Springville, Utah, to play for you tonight. She's an ocarina maker in the community, and her ocarinas have been featured on many numerous CDs, including Tingstad and Rumble's Grammy Award-winning song, Spring's Maiden. Her ocarinas are polyphonic, which means you can play two notes at the same time. You can learn more about her and her ocarinas at doubleocarina.com, and she also told me that she will be releasing a new line of ocarinas very soon, so be sure to check it out.
Wasn't that a treat? Boy, that was really fun. The first song I'd like to play for you tonight is the song that inspired me to even learn about, know about ocarinas. I heard Nancy Rumble's music and I just fell in love with them, and I had to find an ocarina and play her music. So this is Oaks, my rendition of Oaks from Nancy Rumble. The next song, little medley that I'm going to play with Patrick is something that just reminds me of all the fun ocarina makers and players that I've met through this journey of ocarina making and playing, and especially my mentor, Alan Albright, who was the original creator of these double ocarinas, and also a good friend of ours, Richard Schmidt, who passed away recently. So in memory of those two and others. Here we go. All right.
Thank you.
He's a good sport. He didn't know what he was getting into when he said he'd help me play this song. Thank you. And then now this last song that I want to play for you is not that song. It's just kind of to show my faith in God, and I believe through all the good people that I've met and through him and through my family and my husband who's given me so, so much support that I'm able to share this with you tonight. So this is All Creatures of Our God and King. So much fun to be here with you guys. So now it's my pleasure to introduce a friend, Cornell Kinderknecht. And the only thing harder than pronouncing and spelling his name is to list all the things that he's achieved and all the instruments that he plays. So Cornell is famous and fabulous on the Native American flute and ocarina, and also the bansuri and the recorder. And he has two Italian greyhounds. That makes him pretty cool, right? Yeah? Okay. And one of the funnest things, you'll have to ask him, but I think one of the coolest things would be that he and Chris and Patrick got to play in Carnegie Hall this summer. So I think that's a pretty wonderful achievement. He's also been nominated a couple times for Musician of the Year right here in Texas, and been the top 5 winner in instrumental categories. In the Great American Song, I think, can't remember, contest. And then this year, he won the 2014 Indian Summer Music Awards Best Song for the Native Spirit doing Big Sky. I'm not sure if he'll be playing that for us tonight, but we're in for a real treat with Cornell. So if you want to hear more information about the programs that he does or the teaching or his concerts, lots of great information on his website, cornellk.com, I believe. You can correct me if that's wrong, cornellk.com. And it's our pleasure now to introduce Cornell. Are you ready? Okay.
So it's an honor to meet Cynthia Smith tonight. Another hand for Cynthia and her music. Thank you. I was just talking to her backstage in the green room and had mentioned that years ago you've heard the name Nancy Rumble several times tonight. Well, it was her music that got me to start listening to ocarina, and I went to find that instrument, and I couldn't, and so I kept going web searching Rumble Ocarina, and never found anything. One day I came across this website, and it told a story about how they were searching for this double ocarina. And then anyway, it was Cynthia Smith's website, and I think, oh, I found it, finally. So anyway, I hope you're having a good time tonight. This is the United States Ocarina Festival, and hope you're coming out tomorrow as well. And so the song I'll start with, is called Alaska Highway. And there were two reasons that this song got its name. One was because a friend that I worked with told me a story about during the summer he would work for a company that would move vehicles from one place of the country to the other. And anyway, he had to deliver a truck to Alaska, and that friend was from Texas. And so what he would do when he would deliver these vehicles is he'd put his motorcycle in the back of the vehicle, and he'd drive the vehicle there and ride motorcycle back. And so he rode his motorcycle back from Alaska to Texas. And he talked a lot about was that what he would do when he would be driving was he would drive until the sun would go down, and then he would go to sleep, and then get up when the sun would rise, and then go back. But when he was in Alaska in the summertime, the sun never went down. And so he got lots of hours sitting on his motorcycle riding in Alaska and coming back to Texas. So that's part of it. And then the other reason was because when I had gotten this ocarina from North Country Workshop, which is doubleocarina.com, they were located in Alaska. And that's kind of my homage to this riding all the way from Alaska to Texas. So my friend Cynthia Stewart back up. We've been playing together 10 years. Woo-woo. Thank you. So, change things up a little bit. I'm going to play this type of flute, which is Native American flute. And these are indigenous to the U.S., but what they have in common with the ocarina is the sound-making mechanism. It's just like a whistle or a recorder, same here. And these are indigenous to the southwest plains of the U.S. And this particular flute is made by a friend of mine who lives right up here, not in Allen, but in Plano, Steve Peterman. And this song is called Orion. It is from the same album that the recent Indian Summer Music Festival Award came from. So that album is called Dreamtime. And this is Orion. Thank you. Thank you. So this flute is a classical flute from India, made of bamboo, called the bansuri. And the song that I will play on it is not a traditional Indian song. This is one of my songs called Mother's Hands. This song came about looking at my own hands one night. Well, I was working on this song, working on this melody, this song, and I was looking, noticing my hands over here, and I was looking, those really look like my mother's. And you know, some of our hands are like my mother's. I inherited hers, which are these dexterous long fingers. And my dad had the other type of hands that were great at holding hammers and shovels. You know the type, grabbing things. And anyway, but this song is Mother's Hands, and this is really about caring for each other, caring for other humans, and nurturing, not because we are called to do so, but that is just how we are.
Thank you.
Thank you. So the name of that song was Roundabout. It was kind of about getting stuck on a highway and then you get off on an exit ramp and before you know it, you're right back on. Well, then here's the perfect song for you, and it's on my Nightfall CD. This is called Day's End, and it's about coming home late from work, really late at night, and coming home and a bunch of your friends are there and you just hang out on the front porch and don't do anything and hang out. You saw someone playing handpans earlier, and so John Tony was a big part of putting this together, Chris's husband. And anyway, I'd like to dedicate this song to him. This is called Generations. Thank you, everyone. Thank you. Now I'd like to invite back out Cris Gale.
We'd like to say a big thank you to Patrick Michaud for playing with us tonight. Sharing his amazing guitar skills with us. You can find out more about Patrick at his Facebook page, facebook.com/patrickisaries. Now we've prepared a couple of other duets. Now, the word ocarina actually means little goose, so we've prepared a couple of duets that are kind of bird-themed. And remember I was saying the size of the ocarina actually determines the pitch? Well, the first one is going to sound like some canaries kind of battling with each other, and then the second one is going to sound kind of like some mourning doves. It's called Flight of the Migratory Birds by Mendelssohn, and we'll be playing it on a bass ocarina and a bass recorder, so we hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
And although she already walked off stage, I'd like to say thank you to Cynthia Stewart, who played piano with us tonight. And here she is, her big... Yeah, thank you. Thank you. Cynthia and I met about 2004, and we started out playing classical music together, and then I asked her, would you try some of my things? And so then we started playing a variety of music together. And so 10 years later, this is what we look like. So we got one more song, one more duet to play for you anyway, and this song is called Shadow Dance. This song was composed for our Carnegie Hall performance, but Cris and I didn't play it together there. I played it with Sato-san there, and I asked Cris if she would play it with me tonight. This is called Shadow Dance. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you again for coming out. We love the instrument, and we want you to love it, too. I think if more people knew about the ocarina, there'd be a lot more people playing it.